Outside of a synagogue in northwest Baltimore, a man dropped his child off at school, was walking back toward his vehicle, I imagine on his way to work or on his way back home, and he was pinned by a suspect vehicle against his car. He started to run away, and they chased him. The suspects chased him, beat him up, took his car keys, and took off in his car. They carjacked him of his vehicle.
That was Baltimore City Police Commissioner Kevin Davis yesterday talking about another horrible situation of juvenile violent crime in the city of Baltimore, making the case why we need to have a sense of urgency. The gentleman joining me here in studio right now, Baltimore City Councilman Isaac Yitzy Schleifer, who represents the very district that Commissioner Davis was referencing, has been on our show before talking about the very nature of all of this. So yesterday, first of all, good afternoon, Councilman. How are you?
Good afternoon, C4.
As tragic as the situation was yesterday, caused you to be physically there with Commissioner Davis, you and I talked before about your concern about the rise of this type of crime in your district, and this just really personified it yesterday's attack.
Yes, so this isn't the first time we had this conversation, and last time what we spoke about was actually an immediate solution to the problem, which is, you know, the police are making arrests. When they make an arrest, how are these individuals getting back out onto the street the very next day? And that's something that we had discussed, and I had suggested that we have some type of tracking mechanism where you could identify a person, not by name, because
right.
if they're juveniles, we should not
everything
have their names.
Be sealed and everything,
it should be
right.
sealed, and I get that, but that you can keep track of a case just like you keep track of any other court case, where if your neighbor was carjacked or your neighbor's home got broken into and you want to know what happened to that suspect, you should be able to log in and be able to see that online in a public manner. The same way that elected officials and the police department are held accountable every single day to the general public, we need to be able to hold those accountable who are the other pieces of the pie. And we have a Department of Juvenile Services that is geared towards rehabilitation. It's clear that the rehabilitation process that they have outlined is not working. And if it is a good process and the children are not following it, then they need to have a program to make sure that they are following.
Well, let's use Commissioner Davis's language. You were standing next to him yesterday. Commissioner Kevin Davis said our juvenile justice system is broken. Is that where you are in this discussion?
100%. It is broken, because if it wasn't broken, we would not continuously have the exact same individuals time and time again. We are seeing children, 16-year-olds, 15-year-olds, 13-year-olds, 10 even, running around with ankle bracelets on, committing violent offenses, and it's got to stop. And the fact that they have an ankle bracelet on, it means they've already gone that far in the process.
Yes.
What is the threshold, C4, that finally says, you know, enough is enough? How many
maybe people being killed? Maybe people being killed. I'd hate to say that. Does it take? And my call is to the show, Councilman Yitzy Schleifer, who joins us here in the studio. My call is to the show. Even my people texting me said, will it take people being murdered? We know the people have been assaulted, but will it take somebody being horribly murdered by juveniles? Is that what's going to have to take?
Hopefully not. And you know, and I'm talking about not only the victims, but also, you know, suspects. We're talking about children here, and it's a dangerous situation when you hold somebody up at gunpoint if they. You know, were to try to attempt to rob somebody who had a gun or somebody
carry
who
permit.
Was
absolutely
then we have a terrible situation on our hands that could have been avoided. And when you had mentioned previously about those juveniles in regards to downtown where they had six plus offenses each.
I'm going to repeat it. 10 juveniles. I didn't say this. Commissioner Kevin Davis said this. 10 juveniles arrested in the Peninsula Inahara area. 63 arrests between the 10 of them, Councilman. 63
right.
arrests.
And so why are they still out there committing
incredible.
The same offenses if there's zero accountability past the process? You know, it's attractive to blame the elected officials, blame the police department, because we're the low-hanging fruit. And we accept the responsibility when due. However, in this situation, I see arrests being made. I saw an arrest. We had four break-ins 2 days ago in my district. The police, in conjunction with the showroom safety on patrol group, were able to identify the individuals within an hour and have them arrested. And this individual is a 19-year-old. It's his first adult offense. However, he has a long rap sheet as a juvenile. And so this is his first offense, and he may just get a slap on the wrist and be let out. And that's why, you know, I'm pursuing it. I'm on top of it and making sure that the community is engaged, they're knowledgeable about this, and they can write impact statements and submit it. And working with the state's attorney's office to submit impact statements to make sure that the judges understand that these individuals are wreaking havoc on communities. And just because they may not have felt it in their community or in their front steps, it's if it's in one neighborhood, it's just spreading to all the other neighborhoods.